Today I will make a Dracula castle in Transylvania. We will start from the main tower. We need to create a roof. We can use our level and with the spatula we can draw the lines of the roof, and after we can start to cut the sand. It is very important to cut the sand from the most fragile to the strongest part, in this case from top to bottom. I recommend that you hold the tower with your left hand to compensate for the pressure you place while cutting the sand. Finish smoothing the roof with your spatula. Now you can add one little tower in the top of your main tower. For this operation, I suggest you to cut out one little part of the roof, like to create one support for the little tower. With very wet sand, start molding your little tower in your hands and place it in the groove of the roof. If it is easier for you, instead of molding the sand into your hands, you can pile the sand into the groove a little at a time. And now, with your spatula, you can finish the little tower. Remember always to cut from the most fragile to the strongest part, in this case also from the top to bottom. And now you are ready for the battlements. With a very wet sand, make one shape like a little brick. Cut it into many rectangles the size of your small battlements. With a mini spatula, give the dovetail shape to your battlements. And now, be careful because everything is very fragile, put your battlements in the top part of your roof. With this technique, you have a high control of the shape of your elements. Repeat the same operation for all battlements. And now you can use your water level to draw the lines for the chimney of your main tower. With your magic spatula, start to cut the sand. Smooth very well with your spatula. And now you are ready for the roof of your little tower. With a very wet sand, make one pyramid with your hands. If the sand is too wet and after can be difficult to keep the shape, you can cover your pyramid with the dry sand. Finish your pyramid with your spatula. You can cut the top part. Always with your spatula, cut the base of the pyramid and place it on the small tower. Be careful, don't make a disaster. Make another pyramid and add in the top. With this technique, with the two elements of the roof, you can have a very high control of the shape, and in the end you made a very typical medieval roof. And now you can finish your biggest chimney. The technique is the same. You can make one grow in the top part of your chimney, and you can add a very wet sand, and you can finish the shape with your spatula. With the mini spatula, make the windows in the little tower. Make a last pyramid for the chimney, like a cap of the chimney. Don't forget the spire of the tower. You can do what do you want. One little ball, one little star. But remember, do something serious. It's a Dracula castle. With a very wet sand, of course, you can add the canopy all around the roof. And you can finish it with your spatula and mini spatula. Be careful for the corner, it is very fragile part. To cut the canopy with a spatula, it is a very difficult operation. Please don't be angry if sometime you will have a collapse. Remember, when you will cut the corner, cut it always from outside to inside, or you will lose the corner. The last chimney, the same operation. You can make one groove in the roof, you can add a very wet sand, and after with a spatula or mini spatula, you can finish the shape of the chimney. Remember the cap of the chimney. With the smallest tool, make the holes of the chimneys, draw the windows, and with a mini spatula, cut the sand. You are almost done with the main tower. A lot of fog. The Transylvania Castle. See you tonight. If you want to learn how to do a sandcastle, check my books in don'tforgetthebucket.com. Bye, see you next time.